Hi everyone, thank you for joining this new session of Supply Chain Leaders webinar series. Today we have the chance to learn from the experience of Royal Canin, leader in health nutrition for cats and dogs and a division of Mars Incorporated. Thank you to the speaker, Pascal Valère, who is Global Supply Chain Director at Royal Canin. The presentation will start 30 minutes and will be followed by a 15-minute Q&A session. So please do not hesitate to post your question throughout the webinar in the Q&A section of your screen. And now I'm going to hand it over to Pascal to start the presentation.
Thank you, Nairi, and very pleased to be with all of you today to share with you our supply, our end-to-end planning project about our end-to-end planning core model, achieving service excellence and business growth through end-to-end planning. So let's start with an introduction about Royal Canin. So our company, Royal Canin, we celebrate this year 50 years anniversary. So it's a great milestone for us. This company was started 50 years ago with the passion of a vet, Jean Cattari. And really, he was convinced of the importance of food in the treatment of skin problems for dogs. And he created first flakes for dogs to help them to recover after eczema disease. And that's this story is continuing for 50 years with our passion for science and observation for animal health and nutrition. And we provide solution for cats and dogs in terms of foods and services. Royal Canin, since 50 years now, is part of Mars. Mars bought this company 15 years ago and brought a new dynamic to the brand and put RC in the international dimension. A bit, a few words about Mars. So Mars is an international company, well known by most of you. We have many well-known brands like the famous Mars bar, but also product in pet with Royal Canin, sure, but also Whiskas, Pedigree. We also offer food product with, for example, Uncle Ben's, Suzy One, many other brands in this area, and confectionery product. So Mars bar, but also Twix, the famous M&M's, Snickers, and also our Wrigley brands with the famous Fridan, and all this famous brand. We have really found with Mars family a very good area to develop our business. We have really a very good understanding of our mission, and we really create together value for our partners and deliver growth we are proud of every day. We are part of this company, and the total company sales is about $35 billion. And Royal Canin is about to be the 10% of that. Mars has operation around 80 countries and more than 85,000 associates worldwide. If we focused on Royal Canin now and some key figures about the company. So, we are now 7,000 associates across the world, and each day, Royal Canin is producing 2,500 tons of kibbles across the world, thanks to our 16 factories spread around the world. We are providing pet food to 21 million cats and dogs worldwide every day, with a very large portfolio of wet and dry product with 350 different formulas, because we really provide specific health nutrition for cats and dogs. So we are targeting very specific needs, and we are targeting this specific need through a large portfolio of products. We are also pioneer in individualization for cats and dogs. We have launched different projects with tailor-made product for dogs and cats, answering to precise disease and answering to precise needs for cats or dogs. For our associates, we are really also a great place to work. We have been awarded on the great place to work in many places across the world. Waricana, it's 50 years history, and the last 20 years were years of continuous growth, with close to double or double-digit growth in these last 20 years. So it's really a growing company across the geography. In this company, we have really a passion for dogs and cats and a passion for health nutrition, precise, answering to precise needs of cats and dogs. We can make that happen through our all our associates, but especially 500 associates that are experts in nutrition, scientists, vet people. And we control and develop this product through innovation centers and laboratories. So let's move now to this end-to-end planning program. This end-to-end planning project started now more than 1 year ago. And let me share with you the objective of this end-to-end planning project. We have the ambition at Waricana to build a customer-centric supply chain, and we are developing new capabilities across our network. We have three main areas to deliver growth and service through this customer-centric supply chain. The first one is this end-to-end planning core model. We'll go into the details. But we have also a work stream and project around our customer service order management to be really in close connection with our customers and make sure that we deliver them the right services they are expecting. And we are developing new capabilities in this order management. Third one is all what we are developing in terms of advanced distribution network to really be close to our customers and deliver on time their expectation in terms of product and services. So let's focus now on this end-to-end planning core model. The first objective, the first target with this end-to-end planning is to support our business through our S&OP Plus process. S&OP Plus, it's the integrated business management program, one of the signature process we have at Mars. It has been developed many years ago with the support of Oliver White, and it's an integrated business management, as some of you I'm sure know, with the five step of the cycle, starting from portfolio management, demand management, supply management, reconciliation, and management and leaders' decision. So this end-to-end planning will really support this strategic deployment and operation planning. What does it mean? Is that this end-to-end planning will not be only focused on supply operation, but really all the business management, all the business operation. So we are targeting with this end-to-end planning to also reach our ambition in terms of one set of data across the organization. Really to manage the business growth, to develop our customer strategy, to really have the right product portfolio management. Make sure that we are preparing our strategic investment on time in terms of distribution, in terms of manufacturing, in terms of factory network. And also make sure that we have the right sourcing supply development. Make sure that we develop the right partnership across the world to get our raw materials on time. So it's really a tool enabling our business development, our business growth. Second objective is support our service excellence. Support our service excellence through product availability to customer. What do we mean with that? As I explained to you, we have developed nutritional product, and each RC product is unique, answering to specific needs of cats or dogs. Professional and pet owners rely on us to deliver on time this nutritional answer. For pet health, out of stock is not acceptable during a therapeutic program. So we really need to make sure that our products are available every time, everywhere. The product availability is really a must-have in health and in health nutrition. Our prescriber expect really 100% reliability from us. And this end-to-end planning tool with the different functionality, the different capabilities we will see later during this presentation is really supporting this service excellence. That's really our ambition at Wirecanner. Let's have a look to the history of Future Master, the history of planning at Wirecanner. We started our collaboration with Future Master 20 years ago. And this collaboration started based on our supply and raw materials procurement approach. Our target at that time was really, it's still, but it was focused on supply and sourcing management. So we started with a central planning team that still exists today, where based on our factories. So we had already at that time factories in Europe, especially in France. Okay. And the idea at that time was to forecast our production and raw material needs for these factories. So we created a central planning team to forecast our ex-factory delivery in SKU and tons for the markets supplied by this factory. So all this central planning is done and prepared, and Future Master is in this case managed from the sourcing piece. Year after year, we developed our factory network across the world. And each time we implemented a factory across the world, just after or a few years later, we implemented their Future Master. For this market, many times we had single market factory. We had factory focused on one market. So we started to forecast really the sales, okay, and not only the delivery to the market. So we started across to deploy Future Master across the world, in North America, in South America, China, Russia, Japan, South Africa. And we have just started a factory in Korea, and we have also their Future Master. But really, at the beginning, and I would say with the past setup of Future Master we had, we were really focused on the supply piece based on our factory footprint. Now, with this end-to-end planning core model, we really want to move to business management focus and sales oriented. So with this new core model, the demand planning is really in the business hands, okay, managed by the sales, where we forecast our demand focused on each market, on each business. And after that, we have aggregation at the regional level to feed the supply planning. So that's new for us. And this approach is also by adding value and customer dimension, where in the past we had only tons and SKU dimension. With value and customer dimension, we have the right tools to have the right discussion within sales team and within business management leaders at each market, where we will deploy this end-to-end planning core model. So, a short view across the different pieces of this end-to-end planning core model with demand planning first. So, we have to manage the customer diversity. Right now, we have structured key account customers, but we have also, and we have also in our portfolio, direct shops, we have individuals, we have vet clinics, we have pet shops, we have breeders and shelters. So it's really a diversity of customers, and we have to manage this diversity and have the right dimension in our customer segmentation within our demand planning. In terms of new functionality, I spoke already about the value dimension. But we have also, we will develop in this new demand planning version, the advanced promotion management with a weekly view, where in the past we were more at the monthly piece. We have also, with this new approach, really the constraint and unconstrained demand approach. So making sure that really we have the two pieces to see how we are constraining the demand if it happens. And really, this demand planning will be the support of the demand management review in our market. That means the sales team's discussion. And it will also be the base of all the management decision. Second piece, the supply planning. So based on the aggregation of the demand planning from the different market, for each sourcing factory network, we will have the demand aggregation going into our supply planning, and we will have different horizons. First piece is the long-term horizon. We are a fast-growing business. I explained to you that for the last 20 years, we had close to double-digit growth. So that means that we have to provide the right capacity across the world on time. And for us, this dimension of having the right forecast on an horizon from 0 to 5 years with the right tool is really key. Second horizon is the midterm horizon. We really want to optimize the utilization of our factories, and we are balancing our network on a regular basis based on this future master insight. And short term, it's really be able to provide to our different factories, our different hubs, the weekly demand and the weekly supply planning. This tool, in terms of supply planning, will provide also new capabilities and new functionalities in the area of understanding the master plan per unit, per recipe, and per packaging format. So it's really a tool that will be used across all our manufacturing teams and all our engineers working on the capacity. Material planning. I explained to you that we created and we implemented our planning tools 20 years ago, really with a strong focus on the raw materials. We are producing high nutritional product, and our raw materials are specific very often to Raya Canna in terms of quality, in terms of requirement. So it's really important for us to give visibility to our suppliers about our needs on a midterm horizon, because and long term sometimes, because our suppliers invest for us very often to provide us the right raw materials in line with our requirement. So this piece is where the planning core model is a strategic tool for our purchase and formulation teams. With really the different horizon, three years, 2 weekly. We will also have with this new material planning, some scenario option to really have some focus on critical raw materials. Last but not least, and really that's really an area where we have a huge improvement for Raya Canna, it's the distribution planning. We have an integrated network with very diverse route to market based on our central regional hubs, but also our local distribution centers, depending on the different customers we are targeting, depending on the different lead time we have to manage, and the different order size. So with the new distribution planning model, we will be able to provide daily replenishment from our regional factory hub to our local distribution center. And we will really be able to optimize our inventory and our product availability. And that's where really the objective of being able to provide service excellence through product availability has all the sense with this end-to-end planning new core model. We support our end-to-end planning program with the right people organization at the different level of the organization. This new planning core model has been developed, designed by the business process owner of Raya Canna with insight of our different functional experts across the region, with the support of our the insight of our local demand planning, supply planning, distribution planning people across the world. But really, our global center of expertise is partnering with Future Master to define and develop this new end-to-end planning core model. In the future, to support the deployment of this core model across the globe, the regional functional expert will have really a key role to spread this new core model across the different markets. On an operational point of view, we have a key role of the demand aggregation manager that are really aggregating the demand of the different market, helping the demand planning guys across the markets to improve their sales forecast accuracy. And after, you will have the regional supply network teams focused on the supply planning, on the distribution planning. And on a daily basis, the distribution planning and factory planning teams are using this new planning core model for their daily planning operation. So it's really an end-to-end planning core model in line with our global process and tools governance we have across Raya Canna. This end-to-end planning core model deployment is supported by our Mars Global Services digital technologies part of Mars, and really this this new core model is part of the portfolio of Raikana solution. It will be supported by a cloud solution to offer flexibility and security to our entire organization. So, to finish, really an overview. Two main objectives: supporting our business management through SNOP Plus process, being an enabler of this SNOP Plus process. Service excellence, be the reference to all our customers in terms of service. We need the right planning tool to be on time for all our customers across the globe. It's a new standard core model that we will deploy worldwide. It will cover our end-to-end operation across our value chain operation. We really capitalize on the people expertise across Raikana. Future Master is really our global partner on this deployment, and we are really leveraging more than ever the expertise and the network of Future Master consultants across the world. And it's really a solution supported by our global services at Mars. That's it.
Thank you, Pascal, for your very interesting presentation. And now let's start the Q&A session. Why did you choose Future Master?
So I, as I explained to you, we have 20 years collaboration. So and we have been successful in our 20 years of growth. And Future Master was a key partner in the past. So first of all, it was a good candidate for this new core model we wanted to develop. But also we had an assessment of what is existing on the market. We went through an assessment with the support of our US team, because the first deployment piece is in the US. And after this assessment, the conclusion was clearly that we decided to choose Future Master because it was the best solution for us in terms of functionality, in terms of teams, in terms of support to develop this end-to-end planning core model. So it's a confirmation that our choice 20 years ago was the good one, and that we grew both together, and it will continue forward.
Okay, thank you. We have another question concerning the KPIs. What are the KPIs you are following with Future Master?
It's quite standard and quite obvious. Sure, we are following SFA and BIOS. In the past, with the old setting, it was a bit. It was not so easy to get all this KPI directly. Now, with the new core model, we have all integrated. So SFR bias will be the key KPI for us. And we have some others that are designed around the adherence to our planning in terms of manufacturing, especially. But all the KPI are quite standard. In such tool.
Okay, excellent. How many people are involved in this end-to-end project?
Oh, it's quite huge. So you have the global planning center of expertise, where you have six people working, six experts working full time. But after, when we look to the deployment, to the definition of the core model, for example, in North America, where we have the pilot core model deployment and design, We have more than 30 associates that have been working on this project and are still working on it, not full time, but for some of them full time. For the project we have started already in Pacific, you have more than 10 associates. And from Marseilles, our key partner and our key support for that, we have 4 people plus 5 to 10 contractors working on it. And the future master team of consultants is helping us a lot.
Okay. About you talked to us about service excellence in your presentation. We have a question about that. How did you measure actually service excellence?
We measure our order fulfillment. We measure our percentage of orders that are on time in full to our customers. It's quite a standard KPI across supply chain. But we measure also the availability of our entire portfolio in each of our distribution center. So daily, we want that daily, all our portfolio listed in one distribution center must be available. And we have some focus also on very specific signature product that we follow more precisely.
Okay. We have another question concerning the sponsor of this project. Who were actually the key sponsor of this project?
Oh, I would say all the business leaders are key sponsors, but especially our value chain operation vice president is a key sponsor, but also all the sponsors of our SNOP Plus process. And the first sponsor of the SNOP Plus process is the president of Royal Canin, okay, because it's really an integrated business management project. And somewhere, end-to-end planning and SNOP Plus are somewhere one project. So SNOP Plus organization is one also a key sponsor of this project.
Okay, thank you. We have another question concerning Mars APS. What's the Mars APS? And
So we have different entity across Mars. As I told you, Wild Canin joined Mars 15 years ago, and Mars had already an ERP provided from by GDA. And the planning piece is supported by the ERP at Mars. Royal Canin has and had already a different solution and had already a future master. So we check the GDA as a potential candidate for our end-to-end core model. But with MGS, we decided that future master was more I would say able to answer to Royal Canin requirement, and in the solution that we have in Royal Canin, it was better to have a different solution than the one we have in legacy. I would say it's a question of balance of the ecosystems that are not the same in the different part of the organization.
Okay. Yeah, so you answer also to the other question we had, and it was why did you choose not to take it? Okay, we have another question from the attendees, which is what's your target in terms of forecast accuracy?
Oh, I have no target. Very often people say to me, what's your target? My target is continuous improvement. So I would say, we want to increase our forecast accuracy day after day, and at the end, be the best on the service to customers. So forecast accuracy, it's one thing, it's one component, but at the end, what is important is on time in full and the availability of our product to the end customers. So it's an ongoing work and it's an ongoing progression. So each time a market or a unit asks me, what's my target? I told them, be better than in the past and faster. So that's that's my view about targets. My target is improving, continuous improvement.
Okay.
Because you have some markets that are great in forecast accuracy, but they need to progress and never stop.
It's a good motto to follow, yeah. And about your strategy, we have a question about your strategy. Is it make to stock or make to order, and why?
There was a time where Waikana had a network of distributors, and we were delivering our distributors with I would say a lead time that was enabling us to work on make to order. Okay, but now we have an integrated end to end supply chain, and the lead time to our customer is 24 hours. In some area of in some big cities, it's moving to less than a day, as you may know. So we are on make to stock because we do not have time to produce the product within the 8 hours expected by from some customers in the big cities. So we are on make to stock, but agile make to stock. We really want to keep the agility and the reactivity of our network of factory.
Okay, we have another question. What is the biggest challenge in this project in terms of implementation?
It's a huge project. The main challenge, I would say, is to make the right choice in terms of markets, because it's a project we are targeting to deploy a FutureMaster in our 20 priority market in the next 3 years. Okay, so all the market want to have FutureMaster tomorrow. Many of them have FutureMaster, but they are all requesting the new core model next year, but we have to make choice. We have to manage our investment in this area in terms of people, in terms of fundings. So the main challenge is to manage the expectation and explain to some market that they will have to wait 1 or 2 years to get this great new tool. That's it.
Sorry. We have another question. Due to the different level of maturity and capabilities across the world, how was the main challenges to implement one common tool?
Yes. So you need, first of all, to have the right expertise in the global team. So having people that have a good knowledge of your business and a good experience in this area of planning, first of all. After, we choose to start with one of our most demanding and complex business with high growth and high expectation from key account and from end consumer. And that's the reason why we choose to start with the US. It's not an easy market, and it's really a market where we have a huge growth. So I would say we said, let's start with one of the most difficult one, because we may cover most of the challenge, okay? The second one we added was also because there was a request around promotion management that was less expected in the US. So that's the point. And after, it's a core model that we will improve year after year. And in the approach with the different markets, what is important is really to make sure that we do not we answer to a business need and really have the right assessment with the teams about what we are targeting. And it's always S&OP plus management, and it's quite a powerful standard, and service excellence. So make sure that we keep in mind the end game.
Okay, thank you. Two more questions. Do your production factories make all products, or do you have some that serve the whole world? And how do you manage this in planning?
So we have different settings. We have some area where factories can produce all the portfolio, especially when we have factories that are serving only one market, and this market sometimes is difficult to reach for regulatory reason. You know, pet food industry is like most of the food industry. We have some barriers, some regulatory barriers. So we have some factory in the world that must be able to produce the entire portfolio. We have some other factories that are operating in network with a central hub to serve the customers. So in this case, we can have some more, the portfolio can be split across different factories. So we have different settings, and it's part of the supply planning setting.
Okay, thank you. And the last question about your future. What's next? Are you thinking about implementing AI also in your supply chain processes?
Yes, it will come. We all know that the digital dexterity is the future of supply chain, but it's the future of many many functions. But first, let's also make sure that we use at the right level all the great forecast tools, historical forecast tool, and all the different forecast models that are available for many years, but sometimes in some sometimes they are not all used the right way. So yes, but first make sure that we use all the great mathematical basics of forecast we have in hand.
Okay, thank you so much, Pascal, for this Q&A and your presentation. It was really awesome. And thank you to all the attendees for joining us today. We are very much interested in having your feedback on this webinar. So please take a couple of minutes to fill in the evaluation survey that you will be receiving shortly. You will be receiving also the recording of the webinar next week by email. Thank you again to everyone for joining us today, and we wish you a very good day or evening.